Now, as soon as you get to prison, or rather jail, you're supposed to strip naked, right? And be inspected for gang tattoos. So you could go into a gang database if they at least allege that one of those tattoos are gang, right? But what we're not addressing here is the state violence and the safety of the community. And all of the white, hundreds of white correctional officers in Beacon Correctional Facility, Bedford Hills Correctional Facility, Taconic Correctional Facility, and Albion Correctional Facility. Not every single one, but hundreds of them. They have tattoos of black babies tatted on their arms with a noose around their neck, and they wear it proudly. And I'm sure if we took off some of these uniforms and some of these suit and ties, we will see those same black babies with nooses around their neck. This is about culture. This is not about structure.
So why are you asking black and brown communities to take this risk? Have we not suffered enough when we're talking about slavery? Have we not suffered enough when we're talking about the new Jim Crow black codes? Have we not? Trump is our president. Wake up! These jails, Bill De Blasio's jails, is equivalent to Trump's wall. You all are saying this is a plan to close Rikers Island, but we know that the Design and Build initiative allows you all to say you have until April 2020 to pass it through private and public partnerships, which we know that big banks that just pulled out of private prison is funding this plan too. So if they build it, they will fill it, and we know.
Thank you.
Private prisons, just the same thing. They're going to build it.
Hello, my name is Joel, and I'm with the No New Jails Coalition, a group which is one of the few here and consistently present that is not astroturfed by the mayor's office, big foundations like Open Society or the Ford Foundation, which might have reminded some of you have boards of directors full of some of the richest of the rich who hold Darwinian, Malthusian philosophies that poor people should die off or otherwise be disposed of, hence new jails. I'm here to echo the sentiments of my comrades in saying close Rikers now and no new jails on stolen Lenape land. That means no new jails with the latest technological innovations in architecture. That means no new jails with Starbucks. That means no new jails where sadistic corrections officers are required to say the full names and the preferred gender pronouns of inmates or any other cosmetic upgrade to torture houses that so-called progressive officials try to conjure up to make themselves appear to be of a stark distance away from the same fascistic displays of longitudinal violence of the Trump administration. That career opportunist.
Peace, my name is Albert St. Jean. I'm an organizer with No New Jails and also with the Black Alliance for Just Immigration. I am also descendant of Haitian freedom fighters, but we didn't kill our masters and burn down plantations to reform plantations and make smaller ones. I just wanted to get that out there. And that especially goes for the NIMBY folks who are saying no new jails and trying to ride our way, but still saying we should keep Rikers open. Get off it. There's no way we're gonna reform a plantation. We want Rikers closed and we want no new jails. And it's also ironic that today you choose to have this on the first day of school. It shows how like transparent you are with the community. I guess this is what democracy looks like and shows your dedication to democracy. If you really want to show your dedication to democracy, talk to your constituents about this plan. Talk to people who are directly impacted, who have been to Rikers Island, but not people who are involved with either of our campaigns. Not
All right, so first of all, I don't want to sit here and act like...
Can you state your name, please, for us?
My name is Saad Velez, C-I-D-E. I don't want y'all... The point of jail is for rehabilitation, and the jails that y'all got is not rehabilitation. That's income. Y'all making money, and y'all know that. So that's first of all. You feel me? Y'all get all these taxes, and y'all get these little, like, what, like 20-cent soaps, 20-cent blankets, but then how much y'all spent on those bars? You understand what I'm saying? That's not cool. I did 5 years upstate. I was in Highland, Finger Lakes. I'm 19 years old for a robbery that I didn't even commit. You know what I'm saying? In the Bronx. So that's not even fair. And like, you know, a lot of people say when they look at me and they see I got tattoos on my face, they think I'm not really educated and they don't understand. Like one time I got bit by a dog and the owner told me that.
Good evening. My name is Sean Hudson. I'm a resident of the Bronx and a member of No New Jails and Take Back the Bronx. We can all agree that Rikers Island is an archaic, diabolic structure that was created to enforce modern enslavement, creating a culture that breaks and does not rehabilitate those that are sentenced there. We can also agree that this isn't a debate or argument about land or how tall the building is or who doesn't want it in their backyard. This is about people. This hearing is more than that. It's about how our city's infrastructure is crumbling each and every single day while we plan to spend billions of dollars on new jails. They say there's no money for our children's future, that there's no money to improve public housing. There's no money for that, but there's $11 billion for new jails. There's no money to create affordable housing to help the homeless.